What's up? Okay. A lot of people are asking me how to play better solos, and this is a good question that we're all dealing with. And my answer is by mapping the fingerboard, by knowing more things and being able to see and hear the elements on the guitar, we can be more free and therefore play better solos. In reality, we can translate that to clear exercises that I'm doing every day, and I want to kind of share with you some of these and also do them together. So this video is something that I'm trying to see if it's working and interesting, a practice video that we're doing together. So I'll explain the exercise, I'll show it, I'll show exactly what I'm doing, I'll put the metronome on, and then we'll practice it together, and we'll have a timer, so each of the exercises will be timed, and we just, you know, you kind of run through the exercises with me. We're just together in the virtual space. Now we're gonna play a chromatic scale from each one of the strings. I'm going to start with the open string and play it all through the string on the same string. I'm going to play it with 60 BPM on the metronome, and I'll do 8 notes, triplets, and 16. Here we go. 3, 4. Triplets. Same thing from the A. Triplets. From the G string. From the B, 3, 4, from the B. Triplets. E string, 3, 4. Thank you. outputs. Great. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the sixth string and play three octave strides as much as I can from the sixth string going forward. So it will be E minor, F, G major, A minor, B diminished, C, etc. in C major scale. 60 BPM, E minor. 3, 4, 8 notes. Now I'm going to do the same thing in triplets. So now the same thing, 60 notes. 3, 4. Thank you. Cool. Yeah, it's harder. And another cool thing is to do this exercise with doubles, so each note just playing twice. So etc. So I'd like to continue this warm-up section with some legato exercises. This one is hammer and pull-offs. I'm gonna have the metronome again on 60 BPM. I'll play 60 notes and then I'll play 6 toplets. First time with the 60 notes, I'm gonna use 1 and 2, then 1 and 3, 1 and 4, and then 1 and 4, and 1 and 4. We'll do it together. So here we go. 3, 4. Great. So now I'm going to do the same thing with 6 toplets, and I'm going to play each one of them twice. So. Great. Okay, now we're gonna do a legato exercise where we're playing, instead of 2 notes per string, we're gonna play 3 notes per string, but we're just gonna do the shape right now. It's not gonna be any scale, and I'm gonna do 1, 2, 4. So, literally just the shape on each one of the strings and trying to be accurate. And what I'm gonna do 1, 2, 4, then 1, 3, 4, then 1, 2, 4, 1, 3, 4, 1, 2, 4. So here we go. 3, 4. So now the same thing, 6 toplets. Here we go. 3, 4. Thank you. now gonna do the same thing with A pentatonic. We're gonna only do this position right now, the second position. But once the motion is clear, fingers get used to these motions and the hammer on and the pull off is getting stronger, these shapes will be easier and easier. So now I'm gonna do hammer on and pull off. So with the scale we'd only hammer on, I would do pull ups as well. So 3, 4. Stoplets. And you can double that note at the end or not, it's your call. So I'm gonna do that again with the doublings. So this is basically playing 60 notes and I'm having that note double because when I'm changing directions, I'm hitting it again. Now the same thing with the sextuplets. So now we're gonna do C major scale in this first position and we're gonna play it in core notes, 8 notes, triplets and 16 and we'll have the metronome on 60 BPM and we'll do it together. Notes. Triplets. I want to do a little bit of sync between the right and left hand. So I'm going to have the metronome on 60 BPM and I'm going to play some open strings. So to be clear, I'm going to play right now all down each one of the strings, just in order, up and down the strings, but all down strokes. Great, now the same thing, all up. Now the same thing, up and down. I'm gonna start, and I'll start with down. Great, we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna skip one string. All up. Up and down. So alternate thinking. And one thing I wanted to say about it is when I'm playing these exercises in this tempo, I'm trying to kind of separate into two motions. The first motion is kind of preparing the pick on the string, and the second one is playing it. So I'm basically playing, preparing, playing, preparing, playing, preparing. So when we're doing that exercise later and it will be faster, also work.